Students in the Daytona State College Broadcast Television Production Associate of Science degree work as production crew members in the following program.
Game night inside the Lemoran Center here on the campus of Daytona State College. And we're moments away from tip-off. The Daytona State Falcons, the Hillsborough Community College Hawks. Let's do this. Daytona in the white, HCC in the navy blue. Drew Felios with the Professor Ted Sofianos. So thrilled you are here with us tonight. And this should be an outstanding matchup. Seventh ranked Daytona State.
Wow.
Going right to the goal, and Huescar Cuevas gets us off to a good start.
Oh, that's a nice way to start. You know what, Drew? I mean, don't fool yourself, right? Ladies and gents out there in TV land on paper, because I tell you, Hillsborough almost beat Daytona State when they were at playing at Hillsborough back in January. So even though Daytona State has a 25-2 record, don't let that fool you one bit. These are two well-matched teams.
How about the jumper by R.J. Moore? A couple buckets here. And Daytona State 2-for-2 already from the floor. As Ted mentioned, it was a 106-103 win by Daytona State back on January 27th. These two teams went down to the wire. Daytona State knows do not take this HCC team lightly. As you get a look right there, Victor Panoff, the sophomore from the DME Academy, playing great for the home team.
Yes, definitely. He's a standout for sure. A number of them, obviously, when you're ranked in the top five nationally in the country.
Dominique Gooden has his shot blocked, and it goes off number five, so it'll belong to Daytona State here for HCC, the guy who just had the ball, Dominique Gooden. An elite player, averages 27 points per game, one of the best scorers in the entire country at this level. So the Falcons now getting into their offense. Kylan Green, he's had a great year. Denied as he went to the goal, and look at him fight for it. Green's got it in the corner.
Wow.
Pin off the extra pass, R.J. Moore. Doesn't draw anything that time. Good idea, though, by the Falcons. And it's out of bounds to HCC. So Daytona State speeding up HCC early in this game. That is the formula for Daytona State tonight. Get the Hawks uncomfortable on the road. You don't want them to settle in like the women's team was able to do. And they dictated tempo against Daytona State with a victory tonight. A big one for HCC. Here's a turnover. Cameron James now. And the Hawks trying to fly. It'll belong to the visitors.
Looked like right there, Kylan Green thought it was off. The Hawk player, but referee calls for it to be Hawk ball right now. So they will inbound.
So Joe Villanueva with the inbound. Cuevas, big assignment tonight. Trying to match up with Dominique Gooden, number five, and that elite score. How about this pass going to nowhere?
That was just a miscue right there.
Josue Guyon. Looked like he was hit on the way up, wanted a foul. And Josue, 21 points per contest for Daytona State, the top scorer out of Miami Prep. Was kind of held in check, Ted, the last time we had Daytona State on this channel. Shot comes off from Victor Panoff.
Yeah, just a little bit short, kind of shorted it right there.
Here's Gooden trying to shake free for a shot. Nowhere close. And Kylan Green, the rebound for the Falcons. Running the floor, Daytona State. And the bucket by Victor Panoff.
Yeah, that looked a little bit too easy. Panoff getting down the floor rather quick for the big man.
Caleb McCree. This guy can put it in the bucket as well. 18 a game out of Lake Worth, representing Olympia Heights High School. Now it's Gooden. Cameron James swings it out. McCree trying to go to work in the corner, and HCC is a mess here in the opening minutes. RJ Moore fouled as he goes up, and Moore, the sophomore, will have free throws.
Yeah, good strong play by Moore there, recognizing it was that he was ahead of the defense, and the foul goes to his favor. He'll be at the stripe in just a moment.
So a good start by Daytona State as the Falcons have a 6-0 lead here in the opening minutes. We're absolutely thrilled you're here, everybody. Welcome inside the Lemoran Center. Drew Felios alongside the professor, Ted Sofiano. So
good to have
Daytona
you.
State on the short end on the women's side, Ted, looking to make up for it with an awesome men's performance. This men's team, they have been something else. 25-2 right now, ranked number 7 in the country. It's been a dream season for Coach Cantus.
Yes, and honestly, the program that he's cultivated already has been absolutely amazing during his short tenure. So I think we're going to see a lot more. And I tell you right now, though, guys, we're in for something special because these two teams, they went head-to-head. Drew Felios just mentioned just a little bit ago, only a 3-point difference, 103-106 at HCC. And you said it, Drew. I mean, what are we in store for? But right now, Daytona State off to the from the blocks, a quick start, 6-0.
RJ Moore at the line. Moore, one of those role players, has come off the bench this year, also got the starting nod. Daytona State is missing two key players tonight. Dylan Diaz and Braylon Garcia, two really good players, are not in the lineup. So the Falcons have to have bigger contributions from other people like Moore.
That's right. They're going to have to pick up the slack. But, hey, that's what you rely on, right? When somebody either gets hurt or is not feeling well, you have to have that bench to say, okay, you got to step it up. What an off-balance play right there, huh?
Finally a bucket. 10. Cameron James.
Whoa.
Gets HCC off the snide.
And Cameron James doing in both ends of the court just now. What a great block on the much taller number 11 who just came off, RJ Moore.
First substitution, Daytona State, Isaiah Dorsius, the freshman from Orlando, checks in. Had some big three-pointers last time Falcons were on WDSC-TV, but he steps out of bounds there.
Yeah, Dorsius, he tried to catapult himself. He was free. He just stepped on the line. Would have had an easy bucket.
Sean Congleton, number 24. Down low to Cameron James. James isolating, stepping through. Ball comes off.
Yeah, great zone defense there.
Kylan Green now resetting for Daytona State.
The general on the floor for Daytona State. Takes it to the hole and draws the foul. Very aggressive, good play. He's so quick. I mean, it only takes him, you know, not even two steps to get around you. You know, when you have both talent with the fundamentals and quickness as he has it, that's the ingredients for an incredible player.
Kylan Green at the line. This is the guy for Daytona State, highly recruited. Sam Houston State, Siena. Inquiring about his services. Coach Cantons, what a season he's had, his third tenure. third year, rather, I should say, here at Daytona State as Kylan Green able to cash in.
Right now, a crowd is kind of laying back a little bit. Maybe too much pizza and popcorn.
Oh, how about that three? Wow. Malik Banks stepping up. Sophomore out of Bradenton, knocking one home.
Yeah, just stepped into the game a minute ago. Showing value for the Hawks.
How about that sweeping shot by Panoff?
Wow.
Victor Panoff. Honed his skills at the DME Academy close by. He is committed to Lemoyne. That's in upstate New York. Muscling his way in. This one comes up short. That's Jaden Azomo. Here come the Falcons. Cuevas, the crafty guard.
What are you talking about getting up?
Here's Josue Grullon out for the three as Dorsius can't put it in.
Way too strong there.
Look out, the breakaway. Yeah,
that unfortunate, you know, not hitting off the iron caused that.
Cuevas.
Cuevas a bit unlucky there.
From the elbow, this one goes down. Well executed by Jaden Azomo. Averages 15 a game out of Syracuse, New York. And it's now a two-point game here. Falcons with an 11-9 lead. That's how you get your own shot. Kylan Green.
Oh, man. Using that body, Kylan Green, my goodness.
Some tremendous individual talent on the floor tonight. Congleton now. Here's the high man, Gooden. For HCC has not been able to score just yet. Bam, there it is.
Wow.
Spoke a little too soon.
Man, it smelled like butter. I mean, geez, what a smooth shot that was. Jiminy made that look effortless.
Panoff now taking things into his own hands. Little spin move. Use that pivot foot. Ball comes out though, and now the Hawks want to run. HCC from the west coast of Florida all the way here to the east coast.
Nicely done. Grullon.
Josue Grullon out to Green. Remember, Grullon's not really lit it up here on television. Averages over 20, Ted, but
yeah.
I want to really see him want the basketball and have a big night here on WDSC TV.
You mentioned that he averages over 20, and there's a big miss. Wow.
Now it's Gooden. Tried to slow it up. Had a bit of a late whistle there. So our officials tonight, Jesse Applebaum, Charles Howell Jr., and Daniel Apons. And that call made by Charles Howell Jr. And we hope the officiating in this game is better than in the women's game.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like to get on any zebras, right? I mean, I've dealt with them my whole life in the sports that I've played. But you just don't like to see, at the very end, when the official calls dominant play. If they dominate play, I mean, you're really taking something away from, you know, the outcome of the game. Here's a great look at that foul. Yeah, just hooked that left arm right there, number four. Got called for it. Cuevas.
So Dominic Gooden able to draw it. Daytona State coming off a win against Polk State. That game was on Saturday, 95-87. But get this, the two Falcons losses.
Yeah.
Man, are you kidding me? To Eastern Florida, the arch rival. They've played them twice, Ted, come up empty both times. I asked Coach Cantons, do they just have your number right now? He said, Drew, in that game, it just became a little bit too much. I'm going to take over. I'm going to win. It wasn't us playing like a team, like we know we can play.
Right.
And when it becomes a me game, it's tough to take down a team like Eastern Florida.
Right. If, you know, how many passes, you know, you've got a guy, let's say, like, you know, great coach, Syracuse, you know, Jim Boeheim. One of the things that he used to, you know, cement into his players that I want every single one of you, you know, 10 fingers, you know, five times throughout. Five passes in each and everybody's fingers. And, you know, you're working it around. You're getting everybody interdependently playing. Not independently playing, right? That's the difference.
So Colin Green. For Daytona State, Cameron Coachman also in the game, number 32.
Wow, yeah.
That's a strong take by Isaiah Dorsius.
So, I mean, again, a late whistle. I mean, that. I'd like to see that blown just a little bit quicker. I mean, they were both on the ground on the floor when the whistle was called. And here it is. Here he is. Watch, he's right there in the semicircle. You know, got fouled and pulled. And... again, delayed whistle, okay. He's putting it up. 14-14, folks. 12 minutes remaining.
Isaiah Dorsius did not have any offers out of high school. So he comes to Daytona State here, and he has a chance to really take his game to the next level, get a scholarship at a big-time college. That is pretty cool. Gooden trying to make something happen. A little too much dribbling that time.
There it is, when the eyes try to take over too much. Not to say that he doesn't have the talent at all. You know, utilize, you know, your players. Give it give and go. You know, back in, you know, when I used to coach soccer, we call it a wall ball, give and go here at basketball.
Now it's Bruce G. Shot clock winding down. G with a fadeaway. HCC going to get one more chance.
Kind of missed out on the box on the backs out there.
Banks tries to take it in. Good defense. Judd Cohn comes up with it for the Falcons.
That Banks into way too much traffic right there. Oh.
Dorsius got caught in the air. Hawks now 2-on-1. Finished. And the foul, Caleb McCree. So Falcons, again, going with their reserves here. And this was sort of a wild sequence. It was a 2-on-1, then it became a 3-on-2, then it became a 4-on-3.
Good job keeping up with that, Drew.
Yeah, Daytona State was outnumbered no matter how you sliced it that time.
And lucky just to have 2 points. Now, again, 16-15. Guests are up. Hawks got to feel good right now as we get almost midway to the first half.
Cuevas. Rather, that's Dorsius with the shot. Sedmo Basher handling here for HCC. You know, see the man-to-man defense applied by Daytona State.
Yeah, noticeably, Drew, Grillon not in the lineup right now.
Open shot. That's the one they want, but can't put it in. Good rebound by Penhoff. Now Kylan Green, the orchestrator. Oh, got to the rim, man. Just could not cash in. This is Gooden. Nice move.
Wow. Such a peripheral view there.
Dorsius slicing free. Open jumper from the corner. Now it's McCree. This is a run by HCC. They got Daytona State a little out of sorts here. And we're going to have a timeout. As the Falcons go to the bench, HCC, nice run here. As we've got 9:47 left to play in the first half.
You know, Daytona State, 16th in the nation with three-pointers, and just really not showing that statistic so far with the, you know, midway in. And if I remember correctly, Drew, you know, television time that we had last time together, you know, they were having the same problem.
Halifax Health is a proud supporter of Falcon Athletics and is the official healthcare provider for the Falcon Athletic Program. Halifax Health also looking for its next healthcare superstar. You can find out how to become one at halifaxhealth.org/education-to-employment. Halifax Health and Daytona State, the great partnership. Daytona State continues to grow as a college. This athletic program is blowing up. I had a chance to talk to Will Dunn, athletic director, before this game, Ted, and he went on and on about how flag football is coming here on campus at Daytona State, and it is a women's game that has just exploded in popularity, and it is going to become a reality here in Falcon
Country.
Yeah,
it's taken off. I can't say as much as pickleball, which I've heard you on ESPN, by the way, doing a heck of a job, Drew, with pickleball, but yeah. Flag football has certainly taken off for the ladies. Really looking forward to be a spectator at some of their games coming up.
Cameron James fouled, and he'll go to the line now for HCC. This guy, good for 15 a game, comes from Apopka. Leesburg High School represented. Hear the noisemakers in the crowd. Fans have come here to really get behind Daytona State. Falcons have got to give them something to cheer for.
Falcons down by four.
Bit of a dry spell here for the home team.
Yeah, they've had some great open looks on the threes.
How about this fake? Penoff. Inside.
Wow.
Puts it in off the glass.
With the spin, did you see the spin on the ball from the left hand? That was pretty cool.
Victor Panoff will go to the line. He had 26 points and 8 rebounds Saturday night against Polk State. So he is playing some great basketball right now.
See if he can convert it. No.
Now it's Malik Banks backing things out. Macri.
Partially blocked.
Josue Grullon. Victor Panoff left open. Run down in the corner. Judd Cohn. Good hustle play.
Cuevas orchestrating.
Panoff wants it. This is the guy that's going to have to play big tonight, Ted.
Wow.
Oh, he goes down, and he right now is holding his right ankle. That's a scary scene. Hopefully he is okay as Gooden drills it on the other end. So Victor Panoff gingerly now walking off the court.
Yeah,
looked like he stepped on somebody's foot that time.
I couldn't tell. Yeah, like you said, it looked like he stepped on somebody's foot. Hopefully he's okay.
So frustrated as he leaves the court. Now here's Huescar Cuevas. Judd Cohn took a step in.
Wow. Just dry.
Malik Banks. This is Panoff, and watch this, right there. See, he steps on the foot of the defender, Jaden Azomo.
And he rolled it, and he rolled it. Oh, that hurts. That hurts like heck. That is definitely going to blow up a little bit. It depends how severe the rollover was.
So that sends Malik Banks to the line here. Falcons are going to have to overcome some adversity here tonight if Panoff cannot come back.
Oh, this could have been a bad dilemma for them. Three Daytona Staters almost put it out on themselves, but luckily they got the ball back.
Here's Grullon stepping through.
Nothing. Can go down for Grullon right now. 0 for 4.
Dominique Gooden. Tough shot, off balance. Able to get it back, though. Scramble for the basketball, and now it's Grullon coming away with it. Look out from behind. And what do we have? An offensive foul here, I believe. Are they going to get Kylan Green, who ran over a defender? Yes, they will.
I'm sorry, my eyes on folks back home. I wish I saw exactly what happened. It was out of the camera's view, and I think most others.
Congleton, crowd a little quiet right now. I think they're a little shocked at what's going down. Mo Basher pulling up.
Wow.
Another opportunity.
Too many.
Great job. Kylan Green comes away with it. Grouillon, up and in.
And they're calling a charge. Okay. See this, watch this, folks. He's there late and he's still moving his feet. That is not a charge. That's almost impossible. you can't be moving your feet, folks, and get a charge call. So,
and now they call another one right there on that end. That's
I hope I don't see a replay of what I saw in the ladies' game, Drew, where the referees, I don't know what they're watching on a couple already.
So Mo Basher at the line here. The freshman from Denver, Colorado. If you are Daytona State, it's tough because you're playing shorthanded tonight, and then you're right, Ted, it's almost like you're playing against an extra guy on the court. Officiating is so not in your favor. There's Grillon finally puts it in.
And Grillon, again, he was pushed in the back. That should have been a foul, once again, a missed call.
Malik Banks, Congleton. Here's Grillon. The sophomore going to try and put the game in his hands. Tried the lob. Kylan Green came down with it.
Kylan Green, 6 foot tall, and was the tallest guy jumping on that play right there to get the two. So home team only down by one now, Drew.
Sometimes you need something to fire you up. Yeah. Maybe that was the trick. Mo Basher. Very patient are the Hawks. Nice jump shot. This one goes in and out, though. And Kylan Green with it for Daytona State once more.
Gonna slow it down a little bit. That's the right play.
As I said, Grouillon gonna have to put a little bit more on his plate tonight.
I would not want to guard him. There was another foul.
Oh, Cuevas tried to save it. And it'll be out of bounds to the team from Tampa.
Drew, this play just happened to us right in front. Grillon was actually smacked in the face.
And I believe that's the mother of one of the Daytona State players, I believe.
Yes, number 33, Panov, yes. So there she is, getting into it right there with
how
the noisemakers.
Cool to watch Victor Panov play, that's got to be pretty awesome.
Yeah.
So a tight game here. First half coming up on 5 minutes left to go in the first half. 23 is Zomo. He loves to play from that spot, but can't hit it here. And RJ Moore squeezes the basketball.
You see how quick his elevation is?
Moore, bad pass. Congleton pulls it up. See Azomo trying to post up inside. RJ Moore, good job on defense. Azomo, nicely done. Jaden Azomo, the sophomore from Syracuse.
Beautiful, just fall away jumper right there. Spins and falls away and made it look so easy.
Oh, how about that? Kylan Green once he gets by that first step, it's over.
Yeah, quickness and talent, I mean, they mix well for that young man, don't they?
Timeout on the floor. You see the home crowd here at Daytona State. They brought the noisemakers. And they are here to cheer their Falcons. What a season it has been at 25-2. These are the times to remember if you're a student here, a student athlete coming on to support your classmates here inside the Lemoran Center. We play great volleyball here in the fall and basketball in the winter.
And you know, Drew, to see the amount of fans here, that's great. We were talking about it not too long ago about, you know, kind of a loss of the fan base after COVID. But I tell you, if I was, let's say, you know, like so many other people are, 10, 15 minutes away from the Gale Lemoran Center, I wouldn't stay at home, folks, because they got pizza, popcorn, cotton candy, as well as just a heck of a game. And I tell you, I'd rather show up here. It's free tonight. And obviously being televised. There we go. He's even into it. He's up rather late, you know, 8:45 for the little guy.
Never experienced a sporting event here at the Lemoran Center. It's got to be a bucket list item. Get down here and enjoy Daytona State sports. And we also enjoy you tuning in here on WDSC-TV or on Team1Sports.com, our streaming partner, here as we bring you Falcon Athletics once again here in 2024. Kylan Green stepping up to the line.
Let's see if Kylan will tie it up here. And it does not.
So a one-point lead for HCC, Drew Felios and Ted Sofianos. We've got baseball season on the horizon.
Yes, sir.
Softball season as well. Going to bring those games to you in the coming weeks. Cannot wait for that.
March 7th, it is on my calendar. Drew, you're not going to be at Bike Week riding the Harley, huh?
Maybe. You got a bike for me? I can get a bike maybe for about $500, right? Probably not.
Maybe a one-day rental. Yeah, I would say, Drew, and I know you come from afar.
You mentioned March 7th. It's going to be a big one. St. Pete College taking on Daytona State. That's a 3 p.m. start. Coach Tuma.
Yes.
And the Falcons love the program, covering them year after year. An afternoon matinee, love the baseball. We usually get beautiful weather during those days as well. And just something about the nice, peaceful setting and what baseball season brings here on campus.
You know, Drew, just kind of word to the wise, because I've lived around here quite some time. Get here early, because you're going to hit bike week traffic, my friend.
Really?
And it's going to be nuts.
Well, you mentioned pickleball earlier. I was here last year for that big pickleball event here in Daytona, and that was right in the middle of bike week as Penoff is back in the game after rolling his ankle, and he looks like he's going to be okay. That's a great sign.
Doing good.
Oh, how about the lob and the jam? Cameron James looked like LeBron James on that one.
Oh, my goodness. You know, that was just amazing watching something like that. Ah, miscue there. Leona and Kylan did not. They're saying, don't worry. That's good. That's good. They're not looking at each other like, you know, what the heck did you do? They're looking at each other like, okay, we'll do it better next time.
Caleb Macri trying to break down this Daytona State defense. He'll take the shot. The defender fell down that time, and he is going to make him pay.
Took advantage for sure, Drew.
Isaiah Dorsius usually gives Daytona State a big lift off the bench. Josue Grullon trying to isolate himself. Oh, a little out of control. And Daytona State going to get lucky there.
Yeah, although it ended up in 32's hands, which was Cameron Coachman, and he had no block to the basket right there. So
Coachman heads out of the game. He'll take a seat. Just over 3 minutes now.
Yeah, this half has gone very quickly, Drew.
Victor Panoff, tough to guard. Lefties in the post are very tough to defend.
Yeah. Yeah, though he did seem just a tidbit out of control.
This is Grouillon.
Oh, my.
He's hit, and he'll have two. And, boy, I'll tell you, Coach Dominic Coleman right now is hot for HCC.
He better watch the – I can't repeat what he said, but, I guarantee you the Zebras only put up with so much of that.
Josue Grouillon, in case you're following, he's choosing between – some great schools, LSU, Illinois, Seton Hall. This guy may be one of the best ever to play at Daytona State. See the crowd packing in the Lemurant Center tonight.
I think they're a little stunned because they expected this to be such a difference right now as to where it is with them being down by 4 points. Their home team.
Matt Gree. Off-balance shot, good rebound here by Kylan Green. I love the way Green plays this game, number three.
Just explosive elevation. You don't see that, that's just uncanny.
Now Grouillon, look at the defense being played on him. Tight as a drum. Dorsius, extra pass. Here it comes, Cuevas sweeping through.
Oof, lucky to get that ball back. But here's Gooden.
Gooden, always looking for his. And now put up and in. That's good extra effort, Jaden Azomo.
Just stuck with it. I mean, that's just stick-to-itiveness right there. And the bounce went his way.
Falcons are getting every team's best shot, that is for sure. Here's a long one. And it's shot a little wide to the left. A little outside of the range of Coachman. So remember Dylan Diaz, he's that freshman guard, very dependable, tone setter for Daytona State, not in the lineup. And then Braylon Garcia, that hard-nosed guy inside, I think he's the one at 13 points a game they're really missing here tonight. Gooden tries to draw contact. Up and in. And right now, 23 is feasting. Jaden Azomo. 8-point lead. Josue Grouillon.
Yeah. Grouillon needs to get in this match for sure.
Got to get back on defense, though.
Right.
No excuse there as Mobasher.
Right. Just kind of saying, okay, good job. Nice basket. Hey, we got to react. Let's get on D.
Victor Panoff.
Panoff is going to get the foul. Much to Dominique Coleman's demise or dismay, I should say.
So now Victor Panoff. Mom looking on here tonight. Coach Canton says he is like a machine, just a different type of dedication. And his work every single day, the way he goes to class, the way he comes in the gym, the way he works out in the weight room. Victor Panoff, just on another level. 6'7", 225 pounds, rock solid.
Yeah, you can tell. You can tell. He's not wiry at all. He's filled out already at this young age.
Under a minute now, left to play in the first half. Stay tuned, halftime festivities coming up. An inside look at Daytona State men's basketball through the eyes of Joey Cantans. Stop and pop. This one long. Here's Grouillon.
You got a bit of a breakaway here. 3-on-2.
Grouillon drops one off. Kylan Green.
Well, Kylan is getting raked. That's just amazing that let that go.
Now Grouillon stepping through. R.J. Moore, and just the passing, just not crisp.
Yeah, and Dorsey just took his eye off the ball. That should have been caught.
Against good defensive teams, you got to be a little sure. You can't do the lazy passes. They are going to make you pay every time.
Defense! 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 Defense!
Final 10 seconds. Back and forth, first half. HCC has gotten the better of things. Here's Dorsey is trying to run out, and he'll score here in the final seconds. So Daytona State, hope that momentum carries over to half number two.
That was hopefully a good momentum swing if you're Daytona State, Drew.
Isaiah Dorsius, his first 2 points of the game for Daytona State, 36-32. Halftime festivities coming up here from Daytona. Now an inside look at the program through the eyes of third-year head coach Joey Cantons.
Our team's doing really well. We're currently ranked number 4 in the country. We're having a really good year. We're tied for first in the conference, which would be a huge accomplishment if we're able to win the conference this year. I think last year we won the conference, made it to the regional tournament, and we lost in the first round. So we're hoping to continue to build on that. Hopefully looking for a conference championship, get to a region championship, and allow us an opportunity to play in the national tournament. So we have two big returners from last year. Our first one is number 10, Josue Grullon. He had a great year for us last year. This year he's currently averaging, I believe it's 21 points a game. Been a really good piece for us, really consistent piece, and shooting 37% from the three-point line, which is elite. And for himself, he's done he's getting recruited at a high level, which will provide opportunities for him moving forward and allowing him to leave Daytona State. We have two other returners. One is Braylon Garcia. Did a great job for us last year, and this year stepped into a starting position. Doing a great job for us. He's our motor, high energy, positive attitude, and he's our guy that you can count on every day to bring high energy, be an impactful player. And then our third big returning player is Kylan Green, who plays a point guard for us. He's been amazing just to see his development transition from a player that was really just a scorer to understanding the game, controlling our offense, and this year he's averaging six assists a game for us, which is elite at the junior college level. Looking forward for Daytona State, I think it's watching our players get recruited. That's one of the benefits of being here. We currently have 6 players being recruited to the Division I level that will be able to go on and play at a 4-year school next year. So we want to see them recruited, which is huge for them. But the part for me that I love is they help us win. So while winning a championship, while pursuing something great as a team, they each get individual recognition that allows them to continue their career playing basketball. I think it was a great opportunity for me when I originally got the job, but the family atmosphere within the athletic department and really within the whole college campus, everybody is friendly, everybody's helpful, and we live in Daytona Beach, Florida. It's a beautiful place to live.
I don't think there's a substitute for that face-to-face interaction. So it's a matter of, you know, a quick response from the professor, a quick response from the students.
I can see them, I can hear them, I can watch their body language, I'm watching faces.
When I explain something to them and you can tell in their eyes that they finally get it, that's my favorite part about education.
When they understand and I see that light bulb go off, that brings me joy.
I chose to come to Daytona State College because I looked at their program, I liked their curriculum, and I was looking for a challenge. So that actually was my number one choice.
Daytona State College makes me feel like I belong here because the professors, really. They do a really good job at including the students, encouraging them to do their best, and really making all of us believe that we can do it. So.
I decided to go back to school and I chose nursing.
It's time to claim your career. Daytona State's newest certificate program in hospitality beverage science combines theory and practical hands-on instruction on a range of beverage production processes like craft brewing and wines. Learn how to pair wines and beer with appropriate food choices, produce various styles of beers and wines, as well as how to manage, merchandise, and market beverages. Call 386-506-4DSC or visit us online at daytonastate.edu.
Immerse yourself in a wide range of cultural programs at Daytona State College's News Journal Center, home to some of the area's finest theatrical productions, including top-quality musical and stage performances by our own students. Productions are held throughout the year, including concerts, plays, instrumental music, and vocal ensembles. Plus, the Gary R. Libby Gallery features exhibitions of photography, paintings, drawings, and ceramics. Find out more at daytonastate.edu/thearts.
First step into a career in the music industry is right here at Daytona State College. The faculty in the music production program are all industry professionals with decades of professional experience. Their offices are lined with gold and platinum records, Grammy awards and nominations, and all sorts of accolades for the work they've done.
The number one thing I love about, you know, just coming here to Daytona State College is that the professors, they know what they're talking about. For prospective students, they can rest assured that, hey, like, these professors, they know what they're doing, they've done the work.
Amazing teachers and professors and people who have worked in the industry and know their stuff.
The experiences that they've had and the projects that they've worked on and all the amazing artists they've worked with, I had no idea that people with those kinds of careers were teaching other people how to do it.
The music production program includes courses in audio engineering, studio production, sound design, post-production, studio maintenance, sound reinforcement, songwriting, music business, and more.
The years that I was there just gave me the complete vocabulary of what I needed in order to succeed.
Jazz Combo is just so fun. It's just so fun. Like, I have no other words for it.
The studio maintenance class I absolutely loved, which I did not expect to. I thought I was gonna come into the class and learn to solder and be done with it.
That's what it's about though. That's what this program's great for. It gives different opportunities. If you're not necessarily as studio minded, you wanna be out in the field, you wanna travel, like you wanna do the live show thing, like there's still a lot to be taken from this program.
Our facilities include two recording studios, a mix room, a studio maintenance lab, classrooms, computer labs, and two live performance venues. The facilities and equipment in the music production program rival any facility in the country. Students learn and work with the same caliber of equipment used by professionals all around the world.
I never knew that this was here or that this sort of equipment was available to study on.
It's a little different than other programs because it's more versatile in the sense of having large-scale venues to do live sound and record at the same time.
Students enter the program as part of a cohort. The program is designed so that those students will stay together as they progress from semester to semester. Networking is a huge part of the music and entertainment industry, and quite often those connections start in college.
I think working at Disney, I have
three or four other people there that I see constantly that I know from here.
So yeah, I mean, everybody, after the program ends, everybody sort of goes their own separate way and on their path. But I still talk with everybody. We talk about gear, you know.
There are so many career options for students who graduate from our program. We have graduates working in live sound, theme parks, sound and video, technicians for conventions, post-production for film and television, recording studios, radio and TV broadcasts. We have graduates working as performing and recording artists with successful careers on stage, writing and producing their own music, as well as producing for other artists.
Yeah, so after I graduated, I moved to New York. I toured with bands like Coldplay, Radiohead, Motley Crue.
And right now, I'm producing for other artists and sort of doing more beat making and kind of track writing. And then I also make music for myself. But definitely I'm going toward more towards the production and producing route.
I'm currently employed at the Walt Disney World Company, and I'm an audio tech there. I'm also a firework technician.
I wish that I had chosen this program or looked into this program more heavily when I graduated high school, rather than choosing a larger university because of what comes with that.
My advice to any student would be, don't be intimidated. And if you're interested, this will prepare you. You don't have to have prior knowledge. And if you do, that's great too.
Yeah, I definitely recommend this program to anyone that wants to get involved recording or doing audio production as a whole. It's extremely useful, and anything that you want to do with audio, you can learn at this program.
You just have to follow your dreams and have that passion and make sure that you create those opportunities out of your passion.
If you've always dreamed of a career in the music and entertainment industry, Daytona State College is the place for you.
Daytona State College of Education is forever grateful to Volusia and Flagler County Schools and our collaborative partnership that allows us to spend this exciting time out in the field working with these wonderful students, doing one-on-one reading instruction 4 days a week.
Daytona State has definitely prepared me for being a teacher with all the fieldwork that we've been able to experience through the program, as well as the support and help from all of our wonderful professors. And being able to work one-on-one with the students has been a wonderful opportunity to experience that already before I get placed in my senior internship.
So today, you know, we're going to learn about something that I think is really fascinating. We're going to be learning about weather balloons.
Club soccer, win state cup. You're one of the guys that had an assist. You know, the happiest moment of your life have been on the soccer field. So kind of
in the IMES lab, we have state-of-the-art equipment that help us further our research.
It always comes back to either a goal of achieving that success, or once you've achieved that success, that great feeling that you can do more.
We are going to be surveying the seagrass beds here at Oak Hill and looking at how they're changing over time.
love doing this, coming out into the field and actually getting my hands dirty. And
you get to do everything you've ever wanted to do in a marine biology program. You get to go out into the field and actually do the work.
We are truly building a program here for students that are interested in conducting undergraduate research. It's a rather rigorous program for a two-year college.
I'm going out and studying horseshoe crab populations and seeing where their nesting sites are and how often they nest, where they are.
The professors motivate us, they inspire us to continue our research and to better ourselves in the scientific community.
This is much better than sitting in a classroom just looking at pictures and listening to people talk. We get to actually feel and see the plants in their natural habitat.
I love this class. I love everything about it, the learning of the names of the flowers. Now I can, it's like putting a name with a face.
We welcome you back, everybody, to Daytona State College, 36-32, as we get ready for half number two alongside the Professor Ted Sofianos. I'm Drew Felios, HCC in the navy blue. And Daytona State and the home whites. Falcons led for the most of the first quarter, but the Hawks of HCC came back and led for most of the second quarter. And how about them flying high to start with Cameron James rising above?
Yeah, that's the second stuff for him right there, breakdown of the defense there. You know, they just ended up the quarter. I'm talking about, the Falcons. They ended the half, rather, with some a really nice basket in the last 3 seconds. And now it's back to a six-point deficit. They were at a four. So 38-32, they're down, ball in possession with 12 seconds left.
Streaming tonight on team1sports.com. Check out our streaming partner for all games on WDSC-TV. Nice put in by Kylan Green as he came down a little bit gimpy that time. He's trying to fight that off, and Daytona State certainly cannot afford to have him go down. Victor Panoff was shaken up a little bit earlier in this game as he rolled his ankle. Here's a long one by Gooden, and that is why he is an elite scorer at 27 points per game.
Oh, man, he'll shoot from anywhere with that kind of range.
Gurion has it blocked out of bounds. So HCC has come in here, not afraid, very eager to get an upset victory on the road. They gave Daytona State all they could handle back on January 27th in a 106-103 affair. Daytona State barely escaping that night. Scramble for it, and it will belong to HCC.
Wow. I mean, the three-pointers for DSC tonight have really been few and far between. And yet they've kind of, I haven't lived on it, of course, but they've just been so successful versus tonight.
Yeah, so far Daytona State has not made a three-pointer in this game. So they're 0-for-7 right now behind the arc.
Yeah, that's that's not the season average, that's for sure.
Daytona State's got their focus on finishing strong and then the postseason tournament. What a season it's been. Ranked number 7 in the country right now, Gooden. Going to the crossover and the leaner. As Kylan Green comes out of there. Here's Gurion, he is tied up. And this could be a flagrant foul here as our officials. They're gonna get a foul here. Perhaps a technical on the Daytona State bench, it looks like.
Or the coach, I mean, gonna have to figure this out, but Drew, I believe that was a flagrant because he pulled him down after it. Hopefully you didn't hear that at home, folks. Opposing coach, not very happy.
So it is an intentional foul called on Gooden. Gruyon will go to the bench, and there's Dominic Coleman. Coach Coleman in his first season as HCC head coach. He's a former player for the Hawks. Had a great playing career, was once Florida's Mr. Basketball.
Gruyon struggling at the line for the few that he's been able to take tonight. And because it's an F1, right, Drew, they retain possession.
There's Coach Coleman right there, right next to him. Jesus Verdejo on the right there. He's a former player at the University of South Florida, called many of his games back from 2006 to 2009. Good to see him tonight in the coaching profession. As Panoff goes to work down low. 6-point lead for HCC. Gruyon trying to shake off it, seeing some daylight. Oh, well defended by the Hawks, and Gruyon frustrated, expecting his teammate to make the cut.
You know, all the things we've seen and all the things we know about Gruyon, this is so far not his night.
Caleb Macri from long range. Panoff. And now Green. Judd Cohn, can he knock one down? There it is.
And that takes care of the drought for the threes. Finally get one to go down for Daytona State.
Falcons definitely needed that. Now it's Congleton on the other side. Oh, that hurts right when you get one if you're Daytona. HCC answers. Talked about Cohn's contribution though, Ted. Daytona State gonna need him. They're gonna need someone who doesn't usually score big to come up big here tonight to get this victory. Foul, Panoff draws it.
Yeah, and that was such a nice give and go right there, back to Panoff. He certainly wasn't trying to avoid the contact. Just didn't get kind of like enough of the body weight where he needed it to be in order to put that in with the left hand.
Victor Panoff, mother in attendance tonight, in and out on that first attempt. 6'7", sophomore, headed to Lemoyne in upstate New York. One of two on this trip. There's mom.
Yeah,
so proud of her son.
Got a 5-point game here, Drew. Lots of time remaining.
Your parents used to come watch you play soccer, Ted?
Yes, and you know, it was pretty amazing because my mom never cared for it.
Ooh. In and out this time. Ball on the deck. Oh, how about that lay-in by Jaden Azomo?
Second chance points. Too many.
Pan off.
Oh.
Avoided the travel. Cohn assesses things from the corner. Here's Panoff, tries to put it on the deck, and a foul this time.
What a worker. He's just a worker. He really is. Diehard battery. But I can tell he is limping on that ankle. Oh, that's going to hurt and swell in the morning. He's going to have to throw that in a bucket of ice tonight. Any trainer will tell you that.
Judd Cohn shaking free. Another three. Two in a row.
Great shot. Mental lapse there on the defense, leaving Judd alone.
Oh, a little talking here from Judd Cohn, letting HCC know that he has arrived.
That's right. Take that, and I'm going to get a couple more if you let me.
Now it's Gooden. Turning out to be a really highly contested basketball game here. On the line, and it belongs to Daytona State.
One of the few turnovers we've seen tonight from HCC.
How about Judd Cohn, the sophomore? Wade Hampton High School represented. Coach Canton said he's got a chance to be one of the premier shooters in the country at this level. We're seeing some of that range here in the second half. Did not see much of his shooting in that Miami-Dade game. So it's good to see him arrive here tonight. Cuevas, he'll pull up. Tough shot.
Oof. He got himself open.
Someone got a stop ball. Goes to Gooden. He can't finish. Cuevas ahead to Guyon. Wow. It's in and wow. One. Josue Guyon.
Oh, okay. Watching this play, and him in the air, he knows he's going to come down and awkwardly, and yet he sacrificed his body to throw that ball in net and go for the old school, old fashioned three-pointer. Oh my, he knew he was, yeah, kind of come down awkwardly and hit on that hip. Well done, well done. Maybe that'll really give him some fire to fire him up and finish strong with the 15 minutes we have remaining, Drew.
I asked Coach Cantons, where is Josue Guyon going to play his college basketball? He said, it doesn't matter anywhere in the country. There's no geographic place preferred for Josue. He will go where he fits the system.
Right.
I think that's smart.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we're getting.
So right now.
A little chippy, I noticed just now. A little chippy.
Gooden. Well, he has got some confidence, I'll tell you.
Nice rebound.
Guyon trying to fight through. How about this take? That's
wow.
Brilliant.
Wow.
Highland Green.
So explosive, I've said it before. Wonderful to watch.
I think you put him on the right team. Kylan Green's going to be a force at the next level. Cone with the defense. Green again. He scores.
Oh, great body control.
Daytona State starting to take over the game. The crowd loves it here at the Lemoran Center. Kylan Green igniting Falcon Nation.
How quickly did that turn around, Drew? You know, I'd say this started maybe 3-4 minutes ago, and certainly HCC didn't help themselves when they had that turnover as well. Kind of playing a little bit lax, and a few three-pointers from way downtown for HCC that were missed. I like this. You see it in the screen right now, you know. those coaches, John, the Zebras, letting them know.
Well, Dominic Coleman right there, the head coach for HCC, played 10 years in Europe. He's played all over the world. I mentioned that Mr. Basketball when he was in high school. That was back in 2002. He can still play. You can tell he's a great athlete, originally from Oakland, California.
Right.
And for Daytona State, a lot of fans wondering about the Falcons and their postseason future, Ted. Keep in mind, they're going to finish the regular season. Daytona State has already qualified for the regionals in Niceville. So if they perform well there, they will be headed to nationals. That's what Coach Cantons has to look forward to.
Right, right.
So he says team's got to get healthy. Of course, we got Guyon here tonight trying to step up his game. But keep in mind, Dylan Diaz out tonight. So is Braylon Garcia. Daytona State's got a little time here to get healthy.
And regardless, you know, as far as Niceville goes, the way Daytona State has not had its way with Eastern Florida State. If they're going to meet them, that's going to be something they're going to have to get through. Because I guess who else is going to be in Niceville? Eastern Florida State.
Good take. Caleb McGree, the sophomore, averages 18 a game. He's from Lake Worth. Dorsius. Judd Cohn, he's been on fire.
Wow.
Dorsius comes up big with that hustle. Now the pull up, just short. Now Gooden, such a crafty dribbler. Malik Banks drills it for three.
And right there, they've gone up ahead of DSC by two. That was quick.
Kylan Green, spin cycle again. Oh, he absolutely put him on roller skates.
Somebody needs to pick their shoes up. Left him at the roller skating rink, my goodness.
Now you got to guard Gooden, though. Gooden trying to match it. That's not a good shot. Long ball to Cone. Cone will wait for his teammates. Smart play.
Yeah. Didn't have the position.
Here's Gurion. Crafty dribbling. Step back.
He was foul true.
Wants it again. Dorsey says, give it to me. Two open looks that time. Yes. Couldn't cash one in. Tied at 51. It's Bird Night. The Hawks versus the Falcons.
So strong. Well done by Cameron James right there. He's been a standout all night long.
Dish it off. Here's Grillon straight away. Off the mark. Dominic Gooden. Lots of talent on the floor here. These players very confident in their offensive abilities, and we got a foul on the floor.
Be prior to the shot, so we'll go. Quick timeout here.
We invite you to join us for the fan show. March 5th, 7:30 p.m. The subject, men's and women's basketball in studio. Cannot wait for that. That's Tuesday evening again, 7:30 WDSC-TV. Students in the Daytona State Broadcast TV Production Academic Program produce, and they crew the fan show. So it's a great show. Just sit back, relax, get to know some of the coaches up close, personal, the players as well here at Daytona State. You look on the far end of the gym, the Lemoran Center, all the banners that have gone up over the years, Ted, women's golf has just dominated. I mean, what a dynasty Daytona State has been able to put together. Be nice to get some basketball banners up here as well, because, man, in women's golf, cross-country program, outstanding as well. Soccer, another juggernaut here on campus.
Oh, yeah. Last year, conference champions. They went to the Nationals. Got knocked out in the second round, I believe. So, high scorer, I guess it's no surprise, right, would be Dominic Gooden for HCC, right? And then Kylan Green. But if you look at the stats, Drew, from just throughout the year for Daytona State, usually there's really only, it's a conglomeration of a number of players. They don't have, let's say, a 27-point, shooter in their arsenal. It's a whole team operation.
Daytona State having an issue right now trying to match up with Cameron James. They don't really have a guy who can body up to him physically. He's taking advantage. Kylan Green, tough pass. And it'll belong to HCC. So Panoff was out of the game. When he is not in the game, Daytona State really misses his physicality.
Yes. Yes, that is a truth for sure.
This matchup right here, HCC has owned it. Now Azomo kicks it out. Obasher. Isolation. Tries to take him off the dribble. Here come the Falcons. Kylan Green converting again.
Wow.
Well, he has had quite a night.
It's just amazing to watch that kind of speed within 10 feet. He goes from 0 to 60.
Such good acceleration. Izomo, too strong. 2-point lead for HCC. Daytona State trying to defend the home court here.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Pull it back, slow it down a little bit. Try to set up something.
Cuevas, got a defender in the air, decides to kick it out as we come up on 10 minutes to play in this game. Another take by Green, two shots.
Yeah, he's pretty much unstoppable when he's one-on-one. You have to foul him.
Kylan Green benefiting from the success of Keza Giffa, former Daytona State point guard who was doing great things at High Point University this year. Yeah. High Point, one of the big stories in college basketball, and this guy cut from the same cloth. That's why, I mean, you take a mid-major, and I think Kylan Green's going to be an outstanding player for a really solid, like a Dayton.
You mentioned one of my old students. That was Keza Griffin. We used to parler français because he was from France.
Okay.
All right. And that's where his dad played professional ball. And really nice to get to know that young man.
Yep.
Happy for his successes as a scholar athlete.
Is that how you talk normally at home?
No.
Everything top shelf, right, Ted?
I don't know. I don't get to talk much at home. You know, I got to watch my P's and Q's. I got a wife from Britain.
Kept under control. McCree. Leaning in on a nice shot.
Jiminy. Man. So 54-57. Guests are up. Grillon is come off the bench to go back in.
So Malik Banks going to get assessed the foul there as we come to a timeout on the floor. Just under 10 minutes to play. 57-54. HCC has played well here thus far. Can they hang on for what would be one of their biggest victories of the season on the road? Yeah. So after this game tonight, we will turn our attention to baseball season and softball season. We'll be following Coach Canton's and the progress of Daytona State down the line. And Coach Canton's has really been a great addition, not just to the coaching staff here at Daytona State, but the faculty as well. Right. So well known on campus here in his third season.
Yeah, and I've gotten to know him because of, you know, he does teach for Daytona State as well. He teaches a couple of courses for the School of Student Life Skills. Truly a wonderful guy to work with in so many ways, whether it's, you know, watching him work with the, you know, his scholar athletes here on the basketball court or in the classroom.
Daytona State baseball coming at you March 7th. Cannot wait for that. You can join us 3 p.m., a matinee affair. If you're at work, turn the TV on. Definitely turn a little bit of the volume up so you can hear the call from Ted and I. And we're going to bring it to you here on WDSC-TV. Also, team1sports.com if you don't have access to a TV. Coach Tim Tuma, also Cameron Juergens, the great staff,
yes.
Matt Swiderski, doing an outstanding job here on campus. Long shot, just a bit strong, and rebounded by McCree. Here come the Hawks once more, a chance to extend their lead. Banks trying to pull the trigger. Panoff,
great job. Great job twirling there to get that rebound.
Kylan Green settling it now with R.J. Moore. Now it's Moore, and Moore once again steps out of bounds. Court awareness.
Yeah.
Just cannot let that happen.
You know, not, obviously not the usual for a team that's, you know, 25-2. Yeah. Obviously with a couple of their main players out.
Short from Gooden. Falcons want to run 3-on-2. Grillon, lucky not called for a travel. Just off balance on that three.
Yeah.
Judd Cohn dialing it up.
Wow, has he been a factor for the threes? He's the only one making them, Drew. He's the only one making any threes.
Just huge tonight. Right back at you, dead center, Jaden Azomo. Tell you what, if there's one guy that I would love to have on my basketball team, I don't have one, but if I did, it would be Jaden Azomo. I love his game.
Fantasy league, right?
Look at that. Great hands. 23 as a player.
Oh, and there's Kylan again.
Judd Cohn again.
Oh! Wow. Wow. All I can say is that's his spot right there in the corner. He might as well build him a cubby.
Tied at 60. Gooden going to draw a foul.
Yeah. Wow. Exciting. Drew, we're at 60-60. My goodness.
How about this young man, Judd Cohn? 6'8", sophomore, only 185 pounds. Averages 7 a game, but he has come up huge tonight. 4 three-pointers.
Yeah.
Now for number 15.
And it's all been from that corner spot, Drew.
So what a night we have. Bruin right here, 61-60.
Yeah.
I say the word Bruin as Daytona State goes to the bench. How about the beverage science program here at Daytona State?
Holy
continuing
Mitzelani.
To grow in popularity and enrollment as well.
Yeah, I mean, when you think about the art of, you know, brewing, you know, hops and yeast and barley and making something special out of it. I mean, they've got their such a great program up there, and the facility is amazing.
Want to remind you, we are out and about in Central Florida Thursday evening, 7:30, live from WDSC-TV. Join us for the season premiere as we visit Florida's youngest elected mayor. Catch some high-flying action at the New Smyrna Municipal Airport. Students in the DSC Broadcast TV production program produce and crew out and about. Anita Bevins does such an awesome job with that, and our great staff. WDSC TV, such a family environment, and so much to learn in broadcast television. How about that back door by Josue Grullon? Tied at 62. We are nip and tuck here as we slowly near the stretch run.
Let's see if they can batten down the hatches here for our defense.
Caleb Macri. James looked like he may have traveled, somehow kept his footing, and scores with the left hand. Penoff trying to get to his spot. A little bit of traffic down there. Able to back his defender in, but a little too much on it.
There's Green again.
Hawks with the ball and the lead under 7 minutes. Judd Cohn steps out to guard Gooden. Gooden liked that matchup. And he's got free throws coming up here. Dominic Gooden heads to the line. Originally from Cleveland, Ohio. Went to high school in the Tampa area, Sickles High. His final year at HCC. Hawks came into this gym tonight, losers of three straight. 16-10 is their record, trying to right the ship.
Man, as soon as Daytona State gets a little bit closer, HCC fends them off.
Here's Grillon, good backdoor cut, and the screen roll executed.
Great job.
Perfectly by Penoff.
Nice give and go.
Defense gonna be huge here down the stretch. Good dish off, and again, second chance block.
Wow.
Third try is up and good.
And a foul.
Izomo just does not give up down there.
No, he just keeps getting the springs going. Those springs don't stop.
Man, I'd love to have this guy on my ball club.
Yeah, you had mentioned that, and I think that was a good fantasy league pick right there, Drew. So, you know, you mentioned Halifax Health, of course, a number of times, Drew, but interestingly enough, we have now the nursing program has expanded to the Flagler Palm Coast campus, which they've renovated a particular area over there called the Allen Smolin Center, and they got state-of-the-art simulation labs for healthcare and biological science-related classrooms. Pretty cool stuff going on.
Wow. How about that? Right down memory lane for Kylan Green.
There was nobody going to stop him.
It's almost like they rolled out the red carpet for him.
Come on down. Here's the runway lights. Get ready for takeoff, buddy.
I mean, that's like Ted Sofianos making a grand entrance here into the gym.
You're killing me.
Styling and profiling.
No, that used to happen to me when I'd walk on the soccer pitch. Come on now. Not really.
Here's Cone, three-pointer number five on the way.
That was one of his few misses. Oh, no. Oh,
this one off the side of the backboard. It's tipped, though, by Grouillon. How about the hands?
Oh, beautiful. One of the rare mistakes we've seen by this offense for HCC, which resulted in a turnover.
68-all. How about this with 5 minutes to play? Caleb Macri. Keep in mind, Daytona State missing two key players here tonight, so they've been sort of behind the eight ball since the first quarter.
Wow.
Gooden, the lob. It goes in.
Oh, my goodness.
And they have a wet spot here on the floor.
I mean, what he just did, I mean, it's beyond college, okay? That's beyond college, beyond two-year programs, beyond four-year programs. He breaks down two players at once and does a floater from, you know, basically almost like the stripe taken off. I mean, forget about it. I mean, who does that?
See our officials, Charles Howell Jr., Daniel Apons, and Jesse Applebaum as well. I think safe to say the second game officiated much better.
Yes, much better.
Than
much
the first. Better. And that's good. Hey, we invite you to hit us up on social media. Maybe come in, get a selfie with Ted. At DSC Falcon Sports, you'll get tons of clicks. Facebook at Daytona State College Athletics and Instagram at DSC Falcon Sports.
Drew, you know, speaking of, you know, just various sports that we're looking at, college athletics, when's your next gig with pickleball? Because you know I'm not going to be watching. I'm kidding. You are exciting to listen to, my friend. When's the next one?
Man, I try. I really try. Well, I've got UCF taking on Iowa State this Saturday.
Right.
And that's live
that's
from
not pickleball.
Orlando. Yeah, no pickleball on the schedule right now until further notice. So eventually, hopefully, at some point, those opportunities come.
I think I could even find you exciting when, you know, curling, you know, those big heavy metal things that skid down the ice. I think you'd be excellent with that as well.
Yeah, I hope
something
so.
Something to look forward to.
Maybe I'll put my name in for the upcoming Olympics. Maybe not.
It's a hard one to announce, curling, right?
Yeah. Josue Grouillon out to Judd Cohn. Open for three.
I thought that was down. Caught the back of the rim. He had the trajectory just a little bit off target.
2 point. HCC lead, trying to extend it here. That's off. Kylan Green will run it.
Yeah.
Here's Pinoff running.
Whoa!
Wasn't sure he had the elevation to finish that dunk, yeah, but he found a way to get it done. Mom loves it.
I mean, I wouldn't want to be doing that with the ankle. It's kind of, I'm sure it's a bit sore.
This is Gooden. Cone and now Green.
Yeah, Cone did well to get rid of that.
3-on-2. Pinoff running the lane again.
Oh,
he goes into the wall that time. And this, could this be a flagrant foul?
That's
got
to be. That's got to be. That's incredible.
See, they're going to count the bucket here. Was there, I think he came up underneath the basket, and that is a no-no.
My, that could have been so dangerous. Great replay, guys. Our DSC TV crew, awesome. And that turns into a three-point play. Well done. Jiminy Cricks, I mean, that could have been very dangerous. I'm surprised it wasn't called an F1, you know.
This shot off.
Kylan Green, actually.
Kylan Green, done it all night long.
Oh, just. Okay. If you need a picture of body control, that was it right there.
75-70. Gooden hangs and scores.
Yeah. I mean, how about that for hang time? I'll just stare at the basketball here while I'm about 2 feet off the ground and, you know, hang until the defender's off of me.
Wow. Still an eternity to play. 2:45. Grouillon lost it. Hawks a chance.
Turn around.
To pull the within one or tie.
A lot of energy expelled right there when you lose the ball and so much.
James inside. He's blocked. HCC ball. Dominic Coleman, first year as head coach of the Hawks. This would be probably his biggest win of the season if HCC can figure out a way to get one. Timeout. Coach Canton's and his team, they have had their hands full tonight. They have fought. This is what wins games or sends you home thinking about what could have been.
Yeah, for sure. But obviously he saw something, you know, I'm talking about Coach Canton's, that he didn't like. And so he wanted to show him. He got the board out. So here he is. I think he's showing him where he felt there was some weakness.
Want to tell you about Halifax Health, partnering with DSC to provide assistance for the education you need to start your healthcare career. Find out more at halifaxhealth.org/education-to-employment. Halifax Health, a proud supporter of Falcon Athletics and the official healthcare provider for the Falcons Athletic Program. Good defense by Panoff forces the miss. And now Daytona State coming up on 2 minutes to play with a three-point lead.
Now you, I mean, you're only up by three, so certainly running down the clock to a certain extent, but I would want to make sure that a few hands are on this throughout, you know, my teammates.
Kylan Green pulls up. Oh, just off the mark. Green has had one heck of a night. 22 points for the Daytona State sophomore. Here's a three. It's good.
And that ties it up.
Jaden Ozomo has done it all as well.
Yeah. Very quietly, Ozomo now.
Grouillon stepping through.
With 18 points, Ozomo has.
So Grouillon goes to the line. And he's got two shots. Big one.
Yeah.
Josue Grouillon. 6'4", good size. One of the best scorers to ever go through this program. Gives Daytona State a two-point lead.
Made those two look very easy.
So Grion's got 15 on the night. And now HCC has to answer again as Zomo. He's played so well, but not this time. And now Kylan Green and Huescar Cuevas set things up. Oh, got a run up to it here. Nearly a turnover there. Penoff.
1 minute remaining.
Grion. The three, this would be really, really
that's
big.
Money.
Daytona State comes up with it, courtesy of Judd Cohn.
That's money.
Malik Banks, runner. Not this time. Second try is up and good.
All right.
Timeout Daytona State, 80-77. How about the play of number 15, Judd Cohn? 5 three-pointers tonight, all of them so timely.
And, you know, he got comfy right back into his corner where he built that cubby, I told you.
Kylan Green, though, has been the man. And great job by our crew putting this reel together. I mean, he has gotten to the bucket, Ted. He has led the way on the break. He's gotten his teammates involved, and that spin move is just unstoppable.
What he's showing us tonight with his explosiveness, his acceleration, I mean, there's no one on the floor that has that type of speed. It's so nice to watch it. And the thing is, I don't even know if our TV crew can even do, you know, due diligence or something like that. Because when you're watching it right here on the floor in person, it is something to behold.
When you watch Kylan Green play too, Ted, you just get a sense he's just getting better and better every day.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, I mean, you just feel that his maximum has not been reached. And the next place he goes at the collegiate level, when he's pushed by superstars all around him and an outstanding coach there as well, he's going to make that jump. Right.
I think people are going to be keeping their eye on him no matter where he goes. At 6 foot and the way he can get up in the air, I see really bright future for that young
man.
And
a key for him also, we know he can go to the goal. We know he's got a great drive. Right. If he can perfect that little jumper too,
from
15 feet, I think he'll be unstoppable.
Yeah, he was just you're saying it right, Drew. Just a couple of times tonight, I noticed just not a lot of arc and a little bit short.
Falcons get it inbound. And on the back of Cuevas is Gooden. So we're going to have free throws here, and this is where your free throw shooting is going to get tested.
Yeah, I'm not so sure that Gooden wanted a foul there. It's a heck of a play because, you know, you make one of these, you're going to turn it into a two-possession ball game with 37.7 left.
So this is Huescar Cuevas, the freshman out of Orlando.
Got to make it. And he did. Now it's a two-possession game.
Huescar has not given much of an offensive lift tonight, but in a huge situation here. So that's just his third point of the night right there, Ted, trying to make this number four.
But how clutch was that, right? And that.
So Huescar had 18 against Polk State. He gets four
tonight.
You got
to turn around, guys.
Oh, how about the steal? Grillon on top of it. Who's got it? It's Daytona State ball.
Daytona State ball says, yes, the possession arrow. Huge. So now what are you going to do if you're, you know, if you're HCC? You're going to foul. You know, you're going to foul, try to get that ball back. It's going to draw out this 31.2 that's left. You know, I can tell you right now, Coach Canton's has still a timeout up his sleeve. So if they can't get it out right here, Drew, I guarantee he's going to take up a tee and then they'll redraw up the play, I bet.
Here's Green. Green with some open court. Thought for a moment he was going to take it. Oh, he loses it out of bounds. He dribbles it off his knee, so 25 seconds now. And HCC will get it back, just moving a little too fast that time.
Yeah, but he had the avenue way right open.
Here's a long one from Gooden. It's off. So Grillon gets the board, and Daytona State dodges a major bullet.
A major bullet, because Green should have just taken that to the hole and probably would have gotten fouled, you know, most likely. But Jiminy, taking that back, it's okay. We're learning. We're young.
Josue Grillon, the sophomore. Again, not his best night offensively, but could be just enough here to lift Daytona State to victory number 26 on the year.
Right.
Two big free throws.
All right, so now it's a three-possession game. Just let him through. Yeah, that's it.
Cuevas hit by Malik Banks.
Yeah.
And with 7.2 seconds, Falcons will go to the line once again. Oh, if you're HCC, you've got to be extra frustrated. Felt like they did everything they could tonight on the road. But it's likely not going to be enough.
This will be, honestly, the way they came back to where they were playing before, you got to hand it to the bench the players who came out, like Cohen, and certainly to Coach Canton.
So that could be the finishing touches here for Daytona State, 86-79.
2.5 remaining. I think this one's going to be in the books, Drew.
What a night for Daytona State men's basketball. HCC comes in here. They throw everything at the Falcons. For Daytona State, they were not 100% coming in. Felt like they may have been ripe for an upset, but they find a way.
Found
a big shooting night from Judd Cohn, the sophomore from the outside, and Kylan Green was simply sensational.
I mean, that was the glue, right? Kylan was definitely, and Panoff, you know, definitely the glue. But to see Cohen come out like that and bury those from the corner, that was absolutely amazing to watch.
So Daytona State, what a victory. 26-2 now, number 7 in the country as they take care of business. Great crowd on hand tonight at the Lemurant Center. And the Falcons able to get it done in grand fashion. Went down to the wire, and they needed every single contribution from everybody up and down the roster. We are thrilled to be joined now by head coach Joey Cantons. And coach, you've got a little company here tonight. It must feel really good to get a victory and also have your little one here by your side.
It was awesome. My wife and two kids are the biggest Falcon fans, so it's always nice having them here.
What a game it was tonight. HCC, they threw everything at you. They had all the ingredients for what would have been a historic upset on the road, coach. And you guys find a way. What do you think were some of the main reasons you were able to avoid that upset?
First of all, give them credit. They made 9, maybe 10 threes. They averaged 6.5, so they really played well. But I think the group we closed with, and I called 3 timeouts at the end. They played for 8 minutes and stayed tough and really just found a way to win.
How about the play of Kylan Green, your point guard? He was just absolutely outstanding here tonight.
He was great. I think he was really tough and brought that tough mentality both offensively and defensively. He got to the rim and I'm just going to make it. I'm going to go figure out a way to win the game.
Yeah, that drive is just absolutely outstanding. And then Judd Cohn, you told me about his 3-point shooting before the last home game that we had here on TV. Didn't really see the full effect, but tonight he was dead-eyed.
Yeah, first half when he made that first three, I think it was huge just to get us going, get our confidence going, get our offense going. But Hillsborough, they weren't helping from the corners. That's what we do. We shoot a lot of threes. So it really was Kylan getting to the rim, and he had to make plays because they weren't giving us those corner threes.
It has been a year to remember here at Daytona State on the basketball court. How excited are you, Coach, about the future, the postseason, now as you guys look forward to finishing the regular season and then playing on the grand stage?
So we have 4 more days, 2 more games in these 4 days, and it's going to be a tough stretch here. But we're now 26-2, and I think we need to win both to become conference champions, which is obviously our first goal. And from there, we've already earned an opportunity to play in the region tournament up in Niceville, Florida. So excited about that, but we got to take care of business for the next 2 games.
Finally, Coach, I know that, you know, you of course love winning. It's been a great year, but you also love your guys, the guys you recruited to come here to Daytona, guys like Kylan Green who have left a mark on this program. Do you ever just stop and just soak it all in? What a year it has been here.
Yeah, I'm trying not to until we end our season, just because I feel like we have a special group, and I say this all the time. People ask, well, why, how are you guys winning? How are you so good? And really, they enjoy being around each other and they cheer for each other, and I think that's what makes this group special.
Coach Cantons, congratulations. It's been 2 awesome showings on WDSC-TV this year, and best of luck in the
future.
Appreciate
you. Thank you.
Joey Cantons, head basketball coach here at Daytona State. It's a big night for the Falcons as they take down HCC in the Battle of the Birds. Falcons over the Hawks, 86 to 79. Hope you enjoyed it. We certainly enjoyed bringing it to you tonight on WDSC-TV. A great job once again by all of our crew, everybody involved, and the mostly student crew at WDSC. Everybody on your screen, so instrumental in putting this broadcast together on Team1Sports.com and on WDSC-TV. For Ted Sofianos, for Joey Cantons, and our entire crew, I'm Drew Felios, saying so long from Daytona, and we will see you next time on the baseball field.